So we are, this year's trip, we're going to be traveling around Lake Michigan, up into Michigan, to what's called Roscommon County. So we'll go around here, and it's kind of in the middle north part of the state. Roscommon County is one of the poorest counties in Michigan. Their poverty rate is significantly high. A lot of the community who is there do not make a lot of money, and a lot of the people whose homes we're working on, they just simply don't have the amount of money to be able to make the repairs that we're doing on their homes. And so you'll see a type of life and a way of living that will look very different than Lake Forest and Lake Bluff. And you'll see homes that look very different. You'll see communities that look very different. But one of the things to keep in mind is while it might appear different, you'll also find a whole lot of commonalities. And you'll get a chance to talk with homeowners and get to hear their stories and talk with people in the community. And realize that you might have more in common than it might look at first.
Bus rides. Is that what you want me to talk about?
Yeah. Bonding of everyone here on work trip. It starts off in the van rides. This week it's 6 hours, and it's time to really get to know the people on work trip because you don't normally hang out with them outside of work trip for extended periods of time.
Outside the window. See you later. Don't forget to write.
Well, Carl said he wanted to go through the city. I talked to Mick. Mick said traffic doesn't look favorable for doing that.
For everyone, I mean, there's obviously different perspectives. Like for a senior, it's kind of just being able to hang out, chill with the people that you've gone on work trips for so long. But I think a big part of the bus rides are just feeling out the other people there and just making sure that like you can find other people like to hang out with and stuff. And when you get there, that you're not totally like jumping in with no one. So it gives you a long time to really get to know the other people and kind of forced in a small setting to make some new friends.
When we first got to the camp, it was actually a lot more beautiful than I thought it would be. We're right on the lake, and it's this like really beautiful, calm lake that just like you can hear the waves every once in a while. But it's like it felt like a good way to connect with nature to your religious experience.
So anyway, we sit down in the main room, and we kind of get the instructions from Nick and the instructions from the host at Camp Westminster, and they kind of tell us what their expectations are and general excitement that we're here helping them out, and we get to have a great trip with them for a week. Everybody's pretty excited. You know, you're just kind of arriving and the energy is kind of off the wall. So you're kind of getting into serious conversations about your trip experience and past trip experiences and just kind of what you're looking forward to.
It'll be the senior sandwich.
First night was a success. The beds are actually very comfortable.
Beds are a little rough.
We went with the double mattress technique. Stole some other kids' mattress.
Bathrooms are quite a lot.
Bathrooms are okay.
Got no electricity.
Good first day, ready to tackle the Roscommon County.
So morning of, you kind of got to get your lunch to start. Either some sort of sandwich and either a cookie or a cracker, or usually we got carrots in there. Lunch is iffy. It's not great, but you kind of get used to it. But I mean, overall, you're having a great time still. The lunch doesn't, you know, kind of take away from the experience. So then you kind of break up into four groups. We've got, there's a group working at Kitty's site, and then we've got two roofing sites this year. And then at the campsite, there's always a lot going on, so we did some other various projects for them. As far as morning, other requirements we have to do, we have to get every truck takes a water jug with them, a cold cooler for all the sandwiches and lunches that we want to have for the day. And then also there's various tools we got to grab, so it's either the shovel or the leveling stick. So we just kind of got to make sure we've got everything we need for the day to make sure we're prepared.
Guys, just grab anything, go throw it in the cooler. I need one person to grab a bag of ice from the outside.
heads out the door to the right.
So the first site I was at during the week was a roofing site. The first thing we had to do was, her bathroom was a little suspect, so we had to bring in a whole new shower piece and get that through the window. That didn't take very long, but then we made it to the roof.
What the team's doing is putting down drip edge right here to protect the edge of the roof, so as the water comes down, it won't rot over time. And then we'll go ahead and lay our ice and water shield over that, tar paper shingles, and it'll be a finished roof.
We kind of ran into some trouble with the drip guard on one edge of a flatter roof. It took some time, but we got it to work out, and then that really helped us gain some momentum, and they were able to just start shingling.
Today we finished digging out the dirt from our pit for the patio, and then we took all that dirt and leveled it out, and then brought the dirt out to the path and leveled some of the path in the forest.
We're here at the Holland House, and we just finished scraping paint for the day, so then the next step is keep chipping until we're ready to start painting.
I was at Jim Kingsley's site, and when we got there, I was super scared to get on the roof. I had never done roofing before, and the family was super nice. They were having problems with leaks, and there was mold in the house, and the son was getting really sick.
We were there the second to last day, and there was a ton to be done on the roof. We had to de-shingle it and then re-shingle it and everything, and so there was just a lot to do in a little time. So at first, we had to take down all the shingles of everything on the roof. With these big tools that you just chip it under and take them all off and then throw them into the dumpster. Later that afternoon, we had to start putting the new shingles on. And then on the flat part of the roof, we had to flatten it out with the new shingles. So that was a lot of work, but it looked really good in the end.
Shingle?
Yeah.
Here, we can be a shingle.
Okay, right here is shinglers, and Ryan's gonna shingle, and John's gonna shingle.
So if it's not the red beer, but I don't know it.
The last day, the day before the last day, we ask all the kids to gather up anything they don't need in order to travel home or to sleep that night, and put them into big plastic bags and load them into the van. So what you see here is not only the tools, but obviously the bags of stuff, and it's amazing how much stuff we have.
It's the last day of work trip, if you can't tell by my appearance. Work trip this year has been amazing. It's the last day for a senior, that's like really hard for us.
I'm writing note cards and my senior speeches for senior night. I'm gonna be nice to both write and receive to be able to like reflect on the week and get to hear what other people have to say about me and be able to talk and thank everyone for this amazing experience.
We are so excited. We have built everything that Kitty needs in a deck, but it is not Kitty until it has something living on it. But we're gonna have all kinds of plants that live with Kitty right there on the deck, and we're really excited about it.
My most memorable day on the work trip was probably at Kitty's site when we built her a deck and some flower boxes. It was a really cool experience because we we got to build her the deck and the flower boxes, but we also got to sit out and eat lunch with her and hear her life story, which is a pretty sad one, but it was just amazing to see how like resilient she was.
She obviously had a lot of tough things happen to her pretty recently in her life, but just the outlook that she had and the positivity that she maintained was more than enough, the impact that it had on me was more than enough of in return for us building the deck. It was just great to be able to help her out.
And I remember talking to Kitty and hearing all her stories and all the paintings. And when you walk into her house, the puzzles just, they blow your mind away because you see all these like frame puzzles from like every single different place.
Can you tell me about your puzzles a little bit?
Well, I got a really bad leg. It keeps getting worse and worse. So you sit down at a puzzle and you're so into it that you just keep doing it and you just keep sitting there. Everybody should do a puzzle. Everybody should rest their head and let all their troubles just, you just forget about and you're concentrating on what you're doing. And it's good
awesome.
For you.
Thank
especially
you.
For older people that think that that's all there is a TV.
When we started this project, there was just a small concrete slab just to the right of her door when she came out. And she wanted a deck and she also wanted some timbers. So we put this deck in and we were planning to use the last plank as a plank where the kids could sign it and put it face down, but when we showed her the plank, she wanted to sign it herself. She also put her husband's name on it. And the first plan was to put it in the center. Then she told us that she didn't want people walking on it, so we decided to put it near the house. Then she said she really wanted it mounted on the house so she could see it. So we've just finished mounting that plate on the house, and every kid on this work trip and adult advisor has signed it, and it's pretty special.
This is a baby pepper.
Every day after dinner and some free time, we'd have worship. It was really a nice place to just really realize what we did that day and really get the meaning out of what we did that day. While, yeah, we might have made some small discoveries ourselves during the day, I think it really helped to share those with everyone else, so the experience was even that much more of an eye-opener because we were able to see everyone else's perspective.
We would read the passages and then we would answer these questions like, in whom or what did you see in Christ's presence this week? And you tell them where you felt him the most and where you didn't feel him the most. And then we would do songs of prayer. And we also would go into our small groups where you go more in depth with those questions.
Just kind of talk about your feelings about the day and how it affected your religious experience. And just it was just sort of a way to connect with more people on the work trip that maybe you wouldn't work with otherwise or connect with.
At the beginning of the week, the freshmen would start with worship, and that would be kind of a funny thing because they'd be feeling it out, not really sure how it worked. And then you'd see kind of the development from the sophomores to the juniors and finally the seniors, and it kind of, that in itself just showed how much people were able to develop over the whole trip, over the course of the 4 years, because while the freshmen were a little scared, I think the seniors had a really good grasp on it.
So yeah, every year we do our best to kind of remember the three past work trippers that have had their lives taken much too early, and so Chris Marnett, Annie Thompson, and Ellie Burns have been three of those. And so this year what we did was we bought a swing and we got that, and all the seniors, there was 12 kind of panels on the back of that, and each senior kind of was allowed to work on one of them. So we put either a thoughtful message or something kind of to represent their lives, and the service was pretty cool. Kate Wally, a past work tripper, writes
wrote a poem to talk about Ellie, and we kind of get words from Chris's parents and Annie's parents to talk about their children's lives, and so it's a pretty cool moment. It's definitely one of the huge parts of work trip every year.
Each night at the end of the week, there's a night called Senior Night, where all the seniors get up on stage and they're introduced by one of the advisors. And after they're introduced, they have 10 to 15 minutes, although it sometimes extends longer, to talk about each of the advisors, each of their peers, each of the underclassmen, and give them shout outs, what they have meant to their work trip experience, and how they've helped impact it, along with what work trip has meant to them.
It was a really fun night for me to just reflect back on all the great memories that I've had with them, and it was great to see what a mark that they've made on my life and that hopefully I've made on some of theirs.
Going through being a sophomore, junior, you see all these seniors talk about it, and at first you kind of think, oh my gosh, how could that have such a big impact on me? But when you're finally there, you realize that you have just so many people to thank and so many people to talk about, that it's just really an awesome thing to be able to show people how much work trip has affected you and how much those people on the trip with you have also made you a better person.
The day when we packed up and then left the camp was very sad because it marked another end of work trip. But it was really nice because then we got all the note cards back from your small group, and you got to find out your secret pal and give your secret pal gift. So it was really fun just like seeing everybody for one last time before we all got back on the vans and head home.
Perfect.